Copying HTTP requests and responses for reports is tedious enough, but manually redacting or truncating data? No thanks. Last year, I released Copier, a Burp Suite extension to automate that process with custom match and replace rules. And now, version 2 is here. In this video, I'll show you what's new: a powerful global profile system, performance boosts, and a handful of bug fixes that make Copier smoother and more reliable than ever. If you find this helpful, hit the like button and subscribe so you don't miss future videos. Got questions or feature ideas? Drop them in the comments below. Without further ado, let's dive in. All right, so as a quick reminder of why Copier even exists, let's say that we have Burp Suite open, we've done some pen testing, we've hacked a web app, and now it's time to write the report. So we have a bunch of requests that we need to put into the report. Maybe they are just showing missing header information. Maybe they include payloads, they're like proof of concepts. There are various reasons why you might put HTTP requests into a pen test report. So let's just use this one. This is just a regular GET request to Google. So what you would do usually is you would obviously go here, you can copy it, and let's paste it in here. Now, there is some information in here. We probably don't want to make it into the final report just because, you know, it's kind of an eyesore and it's not really relevant, right? The cookie information, if this was authenticated, we don't want to put cookie information into the report. So generally, you'll redact that, and it depends which pen test company you're at, but we usually use that. So we do redacted between square brackets. And then there's, I always find like the shorter that a request can be, that doesn't really change the meaning of the request, the better it is, because that just saves space in the report and you don't get requests covering multiple pages, right? So I tend to remove these, I call them sec headers. So they're basically all the headers in this request that start with SEC and the dash. And so you might just want to remove all those. And, you know, there might be other things that you want to do here as well. X client data, this might be a custom header you just want to completely remove because it doesn't actually do anything. So you'd have to do this manually is the point. And I feel like a lot of people still do this manually, and I did it for years and it sucked. And so I created Copier, and Copier pretty much automates this. So let's go to the Copier tab. Once you've actually loaded the extension, you can go to the Copier tab. These are some pretty simple rules I have configured. The way Copier generally works is you have profiles that you can configure, and then a set of request copy rules and response copy rules. And these are literally just match and replace rules, okay? So you have a match, and that can be regex or literal matching, doesn't matter, and a replace value, and you can set it for different locations. So for example, request header name, we're basically matching any request headers that start with SEC and a dash and then anything, and we're replacing them with nothing. And that will effectively remove those headers. And so, you know, that's one of the things that I do when I copy requests into report. I want to remove those useless sec headers. We might want to redact or truncate cookie values. So this request header match replace will literally just truncate the cookie header. This redacts bearer tokens. You know, a lot of common stuff that you might want to do. And similarly, in the response copy rules, you might want to get rid of set cookie values, right? So we have set cookie to truncated. We might have server headers that we don't really care about. All this lovely stuff. And yeah, it's just match and replace, but it only happens when you are copying a request out of Burp Suite. Doesn't affect the actual request on its way to the server, doesn't affect the response that's displayed in the browser. And how that works is if we go back to proxy again, so if I click on this request, you'll see that there's this copy request and copy response tab in these request views, right? And if I click copy, it defaults to the default profile, right? And you can see this is a preview pane of what's going to happen if you actually copy this request. So cookie has been truncated. All those sec headers have gone. If we click the pretty tab again, you can see, look, this is all the information that was in this request. If we click copy request, this is all the information that's going to be changed. Similarly, with the copy response, if I click this, you can see I think it removes a bunch of these accept ch headers as well. So, and there's this set cookie here. So if I click copy response, it's going to remove all those accept headers and it's going to truncate the set cookie. Okay. And, you know, there are a bunch of different things. So maybe we actually want to keep the cookies. So we have this default accept cookies profile. And this will basically do everything that the default profile does, except for the cookie redaction. Right. So we have the cookies back. So if I click copy request here, and let's delete that and paste, then you'll see the cookies there. None of the sec headers are there. Everything is good. If I click copy request and response, actually, let's change this to default. Let's copy request and response. And now what we have, if I actually go up, we have the get request here. The cookie has been truncated again because we changed the profile. And here's the response. Set cookie has been truncated. Some headers have been removed. Awesome. And, you know, there are other rules, like there's a truncate response profile here, which will just truncate, I think, everything but the first 200 bytes of the response. And so, you know, this was a quite a long response here. Maybe we don't want all that. Maybe we just want this. And so you can kind of just do that stuff, right? So that's how copier version 1 worked. Now, copier version 2, probably easier to actually load it in. If you are already using copier version 1, then loading in copier version 2 should, and I say should, upgrade all of these rules to the new format. It's a slightly different format in terms of the storage, but it should automatically detect that you are using version 1 and just upgrade all these to version 2. What I would recommend if you are on version 1 is you use this export button here and export the current profiles to a JSON file. All this means is that you can save your current rule set, and then if anything does go wrong in the upgrade, and it really shouldn't, but if it does, you can always revert back to copier version 1 and use the import to import these. So that's what I would say to do. Just make sure you export your rules first. Yeah, and if there is a problem, please let me know. Okay, so I have just upgraded to copier version 2. I literally went to extensions. I removed this one by clicking remove, and then I added version 2, and everything seems to have gone great. I've loaded in some new rules. And the first thing you might notice is, okay, previously copier just had this one big settings page. Now there are three tabs. We have global profile, we have profiles, and we have the export and import menu. So one of the first differences is in the old version of Copier, if you added a rule to a profile, you had to like click save down here, which I realize is just one of the worst design decisions I made. I don't know why I did it. It got frustrating for me. So now it's no longer there. So now if you add a rule or you delete a rule, it just auto saves. It's way better, but you still have the export and import functionality. So you can clear all profiles. If you really want to get rid of absolutely everything, you can just hit clear and it will delete everything apart from like the default profile, right? Which will just be blanked out. There will be no rules, but you always have to have a default profile. You can export and then import profiles from a JSON file as well. Importing the version 1 JSON file should still work. It should automatically detect and then just upgrade everything. So that's the first major difference. And obviously the second one is this global profile. Now, why have we got a global profile? Well, I realized there would be instances where I wanted to run certain match and replace rules on certain requests or responses. And then there were instances where I wouldn't want to run those, but I would still want to run some. Like the default profile, right, that gets rid of the view state stuff here, right, truncates all this view state things. That still happens in the default accept cookies profile, and it also happens in the default truncate response. Like there were certain rules I knew I wanted to run every single profile because there was no case where I wouldn't want to run them. And that got me thinking, like, that just means instead of just creating a new profile, you're kind of just duplicating profiles and modifying them. And that just seemed messy. So the solution I came up with was this global profile. And it's exactly the same layout, effectively. So it works in exactly the same way. You can add rules, edit them, delete, change the order in which they actually get run. The key thing is, with a global profile, when you go to a request and click like copy request, the global rules all get run first. Okay, so even though we have this default profile selected, all of the global rules get run first, then the profile rules get run. Okay, so you'll notice in this default profile, we don't have a rule here in the request copy rules to remove the sec headers, but the sec headers are all gone. They've vanished when we click copy request. And that's because I've moved, in my personal setup, I've moved the sec header removal rule to the global profile because I figured there wasn't really a time when I would ever actually not want to remove these headers. So that's what that does, okay? So I've just moved it here. Same for some of the response headers, right? So these are now in the global profile, at least in my version. Again, you can customize this as much as you like. And so I feel like that makes it a little bit more flexible because now every profile is kind of unique, right? It doesn't have to duplicate so many rules. It might still have duplicate rules, obviously, but I feel like there's going to be less duplicated rules throughout these profiles. However, having said that, even though I've said that, yeah, the global profiles get run first, if you don't want them to run for a specific profile, you can literally, let's say default accept cookies, we don't want to run the global profile rules for whatever reason. You can just click this, skip global rules when running this profile. And now if we go back here and click default accept cookies, you can see now the sec headers all magically appear again. And if we go back, uncheck that, switch back, they've all vanished. All right. So that's a real simple way of just determining whether a profile actually wants to use the global profile or not. So it's a global profile most of the time, except if the profile doesn't want it to be. And again, this is automatically saved, right? So if I click here, go to default, go back, it automatically saves and click through these tabs, you know, change everything. It's just automatically saving everything. So I've also completely rewritten part of the match and replace logic. Everything works the same from a user standpoint. However, there were some pretty bad bugs, especially when dealing with very, very long responses. So there would be instances where, like, let's select this. This is a JavaScript file that's, 2 million bytes long. And if you clicked copy response, it would literally, sometimes it could take, like, several seconds to run through the rules. And I'm not saying that it won't ever take that long again. It might. There might be instances where it takes that long. The point is, it was happening for every single rule, and it was bad. And I wrote bad code, and now the bad code is mostly fixed, I think. So you'll see it gets pretty quick. It's almost instantaneous, actually. So this was a really, really nice performance improvement that I managed to do. The other bug, the other major bug, was in the target tab with issues. If you clicked like response and click copy response, it literally wouldn't, it would like just freeze. And shout out to TibG on the PortSwigger Discord server who helped identify the cause of this weird little bug and helped provide the patch for it. So thank you, TibG. That was super appreciated. So I don't think there's anything really else to go over. The original video I'll link as well. That kind of walks through some of the options. The one thing I didn't really cover is the fact that you can right click and go to extensions, copier, and copy requests or responses from here. To be honest with you, I don't really use this feature too much. I tend to use it from this sort of view. The other thing I could say, so if you are sending requests to repeater, you'll note that before you send the request, you can't click copy request and response. Previously, you could, and it would give a null pointer exception because there's no response. So that's why. So now you can't click that. And this might also happen occasionally. So sometimes there are instances where responses don't have requests. It's kind of odd, but that is actually one of the target issues. Sometimes these request responses aren't actually a pair of requests and response. They're just individual responses. So that was an interesting thing. But yeah. I think that's everything, honestly. I hope everyone plays around with it, and I hope it gets better over time and people suggest new rules and maybe ways of improving it. Yeah. So that's Copier version 2, faster and more flexible than ever. If you're already using Copier, updating is a no-brainer, and if you haven't tried it yet, now's the perfect time to check it out. You can grab the extension from my GitHub using the link on the screen or in the video description. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like, consider subscribing to the channel, and as always, feel free to leave a comment with your thoughts. Thanks for watching, and until next time, happy hacking!